do your refrigerator, the best thing to do is to take your handles off and this emblem. This emblem is usually just a sticky back, so if you take your razor and kind of pry it a little bit and go back behind there and start prying it, it'll just pop off. And it's just a double sticky tape thing. So then the handles we did, there was a screw underneath here that we took out, then we popped the handle up. There was a screw there. When we popped it up, we took it off. So now we've got a clean, smooth surface to start to work with, which makes it a lot easier. Okay, so now I've got my piece of stainless. I'm going to go on the freezer door for now. I'm going to bring it up. I'm going to overlap it just a little bit, wrap it around to the back. And I'm going to pull that because I want to go just a little bit more. There we go. Okay, so now we're on there. And as you can see how smooth it's going on, no bubbles. I'm not even using the squeegee at this point.
I'll be home pretty soon. Wait, love you. Hey, did you feed the dog and take her out?
And then we're going to squeegee it down. And wrap it. Pieces. And we're done.
Huh.
So now I'm going to start doing my trimming.
I mean, if you wanted to, you could take the whole thing off, but this is the shortcut.
Yeah. We accidentally turned off the light.
Okay, we're on 3.5 minutes.
Okay. And we're...
So this is...
And I'm just going to pull this down under. But with this type of texture, it goes on and you can pretty much do a refrigerator with this and this size in about 30 minutes, I would say, and you're good to go. But do your research and find out, you know, how to take your handles off. Usually you can go online and see whoever makes the refrigerator and put in there like you're going to be replacing the handles, and it'll show you how to pop your handles off. So I'm going to bring this up, and I'm going to pull it up a little bit more than it should be so I can trim it. bring it in. I want to make sure I've got enough to go over here on this side. So I'm going to go over a little bit more. And as you can see, you can move it around, pop it on and off. It's not really going to damage the film. Squeegee to even smooth this down, which is really gonna, you know, it's going on smooth, no air pockets, nothing. And I'm just gonna say, when you're doing a large project like this, you can do it by yourself, but it's easier if you have someone doing it with you so they can pull the film down as you pull it. Work little bubbles out and keep going down. The difference with EzFaux Décor versus a lot of the other brands out there, this is a four-layer process. Ours has a coating on it. It's finger-proof, scratch-resistant, much easier to use. Lot durable. It's not like the cheap Con-Tact paper where you're going to end up with a bunch of, you know, wrinkles and creases and make it crazy. A lot, because then I can feel if there's any imperfections, any bubbles. Now I'm going to come around to the bottom and I'm just going to trim this bottom out. Here, so I know where I'm at. I It's important to always make sure your razor's sharp when you're doing this, because you want a nice clean cut on it.